Welcome to Microsoft Unboxed. Every week we're going to be discussing the latest and greatest stories coming out of Microsoft and the people behind them. I'm one of your hosts, Sonia Dara, and here's my friend Colleen O'Brien, your fellow co-host.
Hello, everyone.
So each of us have a set of stories that we'll share to one another, but I don't know what Colleen's going to say.
Correct.
And she doesn't know what I'm going to say. We're going to be discussing...
You looked at me with, like, panic in your
eyes. Because I forgot the next words. Okay. And today's theme is... tech in sports.
Woo!
Sports ball. Do you play any sports balls?
My athletic days are pretty much over. I consider myself a retired athlete.
But you played a bunch, right?
I was a three-sport athlete in high school. Field hockey player, track runner, tennis player.
Wow.
Yeah, you played sports in high school too?
Okay. All right, story time. I am very tall. You can't tell I'm sitting. I'm about 6 feet tall.
So a basketball star.
Right, obviously. I played basketball for 3 years in middle school, and I didn't score once.
In 3 years?
In 3 years. I played every game. I was in the starting lineup, and this is back in middle school where the top score was 20. I would just stand there and keep my hands up, and I still, like, I just never scored.
So you were the intimidation factor because you weren't putting any
numbers up. No, because I would apologize to them. I would, like, run into a girl and be like, sorry. And my coach would be like, Sonia, you don't have to apologize to them when you're trying to get the ball.
I had a similarly abysmal basketball experience. My brother actually told me that I was embarrassing our family.
There are a lot of O'Briens too. That's pretty bad.
I know. A lot of people to shame. You know when you're dribbling down the court and you're supposed to, like, do a layup? I would dribble down the court, stop, and then try to shoot it in.
We're very good at spectating. It's good chat. Good chat.
Good chat.
So, moving on to story time officially. Mine is around Microsoft's involvement in sports around the area. The Seattle Storm is our women's WNBA basketball team here in Seattle. They're amazing, they keep winning championships. So there was this workshop that Microsoft did with them for the boys and girls clubs, that there's not just the sports that you can play, but there's also the math behind it. It was a clinic, hands-on training, basically how STEM can relate to basketball skills. So you could test your vertical jump, so like how tall would you have to be to dunk on the moon, and like tying that in together.
Is it easier? Is it harder?
Definitely harder. Imagine like dribbling and it just like shoots off into like outer space. You're like, okay, I guess that's the end of the game, guys.
L to L, that's what I remember. L to L.
Now you would need gravity playing into it, you know how to bounce it. So this is what they were teaching the girls. And also like impactful their jump was, vertical leap, and a lot of other mathematical terms.
What a cool way to do some storytelling around math.
Yeah.
I don't know, I'm trying to think back to like the word problems that I had, and it was always like, Betty has four oranges, she wants three lemons.
Why? I don't think that worked. There's a magic.
They seemed like so obscure. Yeah. And what an awesome way to like tie your learning into something that they care about.
Tangible.
Yeah.
Like bringing it into a tangible area in an arena they're comfortable with. Like a lot of these boys and girls have been watching basketball, but they didn't really feel comfortable playing it. So combining almost two uncomfortable scenarios into one and making it such an easy entry point and like low barrier to entry, I think it's a really interesting way of just like giving back to the community also. And I thought what was really good about this clinic in particular is a lot of women providing the coaching to other women and to the girls. They can actually see and picture their own idol, just like a really good safe zone for these girls to actually feel comfortable.
There are significant benefits to more women getting involved with coaching, including focusing less on winning or the exclusively competitive nature of sports, and more about the lessons that we can all learn from being on sports teams and playing competitively in games.
Totally.
More of those life lessons, less of the win-loss focus.
Win.
Yes, exactly.
This isn't USA Iceland D2 Mighty Ducks. Yeah.
Great movie.
Although they did learn a lot.
There
was a lot of good lessons out of that one.
I'm going to be talking about Anil Kumble.
Okay.
Who is a cricket player.
Sounds Indian.
He is Indian.
Yes.
Anil also has a deep interest in technology. Cricket does not have a ton of technology integration as of today. In 1999, they of course introduced the speed gun. Like when you're driving down the street and a police officer is
monitoring how fast everyone's going.
Since then, they have started introducing these multi-angle cameras like we have here today. Being a spectator in a cricket game became much cooler and more interactive when you could see not only the field or the pitch from your seat, but also from all of those different angles. Both of these technology advancements were really focused on the bowler. Mm. And even though Anil was a bowler, he said that cricket is a Batman's game.
Batman! He said it like it.
So. I know. He wanted to focus on the Batman. Anil is working at Spektacom now as a technologist. Okay. And he is partnering with Microsoft to create this PowerBat. PowerBat has an IoT sensor.
What?
Like the size of a credit card. It would like fit in your wallet. And they sticker it to the bat. So in real time, that IoT sensor is collecting data about the batting experience. It's monitoring quality, which I came to understand is like where on the bat the ball is hitting. Bat speed, twist, like body twist, and then power. So they're using that intelligent edge of the bat, transferring the data to the intelligent cloud.
Azure.
And then you have access to all of this data about your performance on the pitch, but also like over time. Yeah. So you can see where you're improving and then focus more of your workouts or your preparation for play. They're already using this PowerBat in local cricket organizations, and they're thinking about ways to not only use the data to make the player experience better, but also to figure out like how can you make the fan experience better as well.
I mean, I'm picturing the sensor that they put on the bat. Imagine if we put that on the ball that we had on the moon, and then it could tell us how to properly dribble and give us all the feedback of like, hey, if you dribbled it a little lighter, it might return back to you and not go flying to Mars.
That's the only way that you could get good at basketball on the moon.
Only way.
Yeah.
The only way. It is really, really interesting to see all these smart applications and usage of IoT.
Unfortunately, this box is not yet...
It's not yet smart. But that is a great transition to our next segment called Outside of the Box. I'm going to pick a question for you.
Okay.
And you have 30 seconds to answer it.
Fantastic.
Okay. Colleen.
Yes.
If you could only eat at one restaurant forever, what restaurant would it be?
I would eat at Chipotle.
Wow. Really? Was not expecting that.
Yeah, I don't know if that's my answer.
Do you even normally go there here?
I like never go there, but I was thinking like, what's a place where you can eat pretty healthfully and like have some variety? I never eat there. I don't know why I said that.
I thought you'd pick like a sushi Japanese place.
I'm embarrassed by my choice.
It's okay.
You're right. I think I probably would choose like a ramen restaurant.
Right? But you don't want just ramen because your sodium levels would be like,
that's exactly what I was thinking about when you asked me this question. I was like, I can't say that, but I have to say something.
Yes.
What part of elementary school do you wish you could incorporate into your adult life?
Oh my God, easy. Kindergarten nap time.
You had nap time in kindergarten?
Yeah.
We didn't do that.
It was rest time and you just had to be quiet. I think it was for the teacher's sanity of like, just please be quiet for 30 minutes. I would say preschool is definitely like proper nap time, but if I could bring that back in, it would either be nap time and or recess, but probably nap time.
Or do you want like a full-on bed at work?
No, pods. Okay. I wouldn't want to like be comatose at work. I would want just a little snoozer, be refreshed, and then keep working.
All right, good answer. Nap time.
I had that like ready. That was scary.
All right, we're officially done with this segment.
We're not sticking to any particular order at all. Please submit questions for the box. We will be answering them in all of our episodes every week, so keep them coming and send them to the email address below.
Please remember to subscribe to our channel, and we will see you next week. Hey everyone, if you can't get enough of us, I would highly recommend subscribing to our podcast, Women in Business and Technology, available right here.
And you can follow us on Twitter and Instagram at our social handles right here.